Okay, so today is December 2nd, 2014, and I'm here with student X, who is 15?
16
years old, is in 11th grade, and has agreed to come and answer some questions. Student X, what do you like to do in your free time?
A lot of photography. I like to be outside a lot, but not really at home. So I don't really do that much. I'm always surprised how little time I have and how little things I do. I don't know.
Why do you feel like you have so little time?
Because there's a lot that I want to do. There's a lot that, like, there's a lot of ideas that I have that I don't get to do.
Okay. When did you start doing photography?
I started using when I used the darkroom, it was really when I started to really get into photography, which was in 8th grade, February, for like a school project.
Yeah. Who influenced you into starting? Friend, family member?
My mom actually built a darkroom in our house, but never really finished building it until I kind of set it up.
Does she still do photography?
Yeah, she does. She hasn't really taught me so much as, like, supported me in the things I was doing, which has been really helpful. Because I've been able to do a lot.
Is it something that you want to do professionally?
Yeah, it is.
What about college?
Yeah, I'd like to probably go to art school. Focusing on photography.
Have you thought about school?
Yeah, I've been looking at schools, but there's just a lot of choices, and it's really hard to narrow things down. But, like, at the beginning of this year, I was really worried about it, but now I feel a little bit less worried. Because there's a lot of people that can help me. Like, my art teacher, mentor, advisor, and my parents would be really supportive.
So, tell me about your friends. Who's your oldest friend?
My oldest friend?
Not age-wise, but your friend that you've been friends for the longest time.
I don't know. I don't really stay friends. Probably my oldest friend. Should I say her name?
No, yeah, sure.
Yeah, my oldest friend Olivia, I met her at the plus school when I was in, like, fourth grade. I haven't seen her that much. Like, I don't see her very often, but, like, I do, like, see her every once in a while, like, every couple months. She's probably my oldest friend. But I haven't really had, like, I don't know, I don't stay friends with people for a long time.
Okay.
I don't know why.
What is it about Olivia's personality that you're drawn to?
We're really different from each other now. But before, she was just really nice to me when I went to new school. And she's like a really good person, and I think she, like, cares about everyone and tries to do the right thing and all that kind of stuff.
What's her family like?
Her family's kind of weird. Like, she lives with her grandmother and her mom, but her mom's not home a lot of the time. And her mom has, like, some problems. But her mom's still really nice, and I think she has overall a pretty good relationship with her mom. But it's just, like, it's hard for them. Yeah.
Is her family similar to yours at all?
Yeah. We've done things, like, with all our families together. Like, probably, like, at the time when we were closest, we did a lot of stuff with all our families. We have the same, like, opinions about things. Like, our families have the same opinions about things and ideas about things and, yeah. Like, think the same way.
Tell me about your family.
My family, it's me and my sister and my parents. I think we get along really well, especially with my sister. When I was little, I didn't really have that many friends, and, like, really didn't have that many friends, just because we didn't like, we didn't go to daycare or preschool or anything, so we were just together all the time. Just like played together all day long, every day. So we're really close. And
how old is your sister?
She's 2 years younger than me. She's 14. I'm pretty close to my parents too. Like, I talk to them about a lot of stuff, and I think a lot of teenagers think that they're like, oh, my parents don't understand me and that kind of thing, but I feel like my parents do, for the most part.
Why do you think that they understand you?
Or
what leads you to believe that they understand you?
They trust me a lot. That's a big one. And they're always really supportive and like really encouraging of anything that me and Lily want to do.
Have you ever broken their trust?
Not in any major ways, actually. No.
Okay.
And if I have, like, I don't know, like when I would usually probably like tell them about, like, if I felt bad about it, I tell them later, but that doesn't really happen.
Okay. That's pretty cool. Nice to have that kind of relationship.
Yeah.
Do you have a friend who's a good influence on you?
I would say actually the twins, because they just like, they go out and do all the stuff. Sometimes it's like kind of crazy stuff that they just like go out and do, but like they always go out and do it, and they're always willing to try to do new things. Like they're really open to things like that, and also like really nice people. I feel like I get angry a lot and like moody a lot, and they don't. And I think that's like really good to like to be around people who have qualities that you wish you had.
Where do you hang out with the twins?
I went.
Are these twin boys or twin girls?
These are twin boys.
Okay.
They live off island, so doing things after school with them is kind of hard sometimes. But like they stay on the island a lot, which is cool. In the summer we went to the beach a lot. Mostly it was going to the beach.
How long have you known them?
Like, I've known them for 4 years, but we've been friends for like 2 years.
So how have they been a good influence on you? Or in what ways? Like,
I noticed, I noticed that I've been a little bit nicer to people. Like, I've been working on that in general, because I think it's, like, important, and I always kind of have, like, everyone tries to be nice, but, seeing the way that they deal with things and respond to things.
Cool. What do you think that has to do with?
What do you mean?
Like, why is it that they respond differently? What do you think that, what's the root of their response to life?
I've been to their house. Actually, I lived at their house for a time, because it's comforted, and, like, I don't know. And their family is, like, they're, like, it's kind of similar to my family. Like, they're close to their siblings, and they have another brother they're really close to, and their parents are, like, really, really nice people. And they're, like, really accepting. So I think mostly their parents. Like, they're really accepting of everyone. And they've also met a lot of different kinds of people. And, like, various crazy things that they do. I think they've met a lot of different kinds of people and have been exposed to a lot of different ideas.
What kind of crazy things do they do?
It's not so much, like, the things that they do are really crazy, but it's that they do so many of these kinds. Like, they do, like, they do a lot of, like, acrobatic stuff. Like, they're always, like, flipping around and, like, all this stuff. And it's extra funny because they're twins. It's, like, it's a real performance every time they do those things. They do ultimate frisbee. They go dancing a lot. They have a lot of mentorships that are kind of unique. Like, they've been building a boat, but then Dylan's been doing martial arts and dance and theater. And
so what are these mentorships through school?
Yeah, they're through school. They've, a lot of them started through school, but then they continue them outside of school.
Okay. Do you have a bad, do you have a friend who's a bad influence on you?
That's a tricky question. Alright, so friends that have influenced me negatively. I'd say, well, usually, I wouldn't say that. I've had friends who've done, like, things that I didn't agree with, but I don't think it influenced me that negatively. Like, when, like, I have a group of friends who, like, they spend a lot of their time, like, smoking and stuff, but I haven't really, I'm not really around them when they do that. Like, it's hard to be friends with them and not do that, but I think, like, I stay friendly with them. And, but, I don't know.
Why do you think they smoke and do that other stuff?
I don't really. I think a lot of it is because they're just bored and they don't have, they're not motivated to do anything else. And then when they do that, like, it just makes it worse and worse, and then they're like, they keep being less likely to do other things.
What are their home lives like?
Some of them, a lot of them are kind of, it's, there's like a variety, I guess. Some people, like a few, have really good home lives. Others, like, are in a difficult situation, but they're close to their families. And some don't get along with families at all, and they're in a bad situation.
Bad situation, like abusive situation?
No, not abusive, but like they don't have a lot of money, or like they do. I don't know. Mostly, it's because people don't have a lot of money, I think. And they, or, yeah, or, like, there's something that caught, like, where their parents aren't able to be that supportive to them. Or if there's a few people who have, like, some, like, mental issue or issues that they have to kind of overcome, I guess. And I think that smoking and doing those other things is like a negative way to deal with that, but I don't know. I could, like, there's always something that's hard, really hard for them that causes them to do that, I think.
Do you ever deal with peer pressure from these guys?
Not so much. I think probably at the beginning, people, like, asked me to do things, but then once I kind of, like, established that I didn't want to, like, everyone knows and, like, respects that.
Have you ever had conflict with a friend?
Yes.
Yeah. How would you deal with it?
I don't know. Well, I guess there's a couple things that I think of. Like, first of all, like, when people are smoking and stuff, sometimes, like, I try to avoid talking about, like, why I don't, but sometimes it comes up. I'm like, I've had a couple arguments with people about that. But that's not really a big deal. I'm like, you can get over that super quickly.
Why do you not?
Just because I think that it takes up so much of your time, and, like, even, like, you're not talking about, like, the health effects and all that, because that's always, like, debated, but from what I've just seen, like, it's just, it really hurts the people who do it, and I don't want that to happen to me, and it takes up, like, so much of who you are gets devoted to that, and, like, there's no room for anything else, eventually, like, and I want to be able to do other things, and I don't want to be labeled as that either. I think it's it's just not, like, it's never something that I've been really compelled to do either. Like, there's no real reason why I should do it. There's a lot of reasons why I shouldn't.
Are there any, is there anybody in your life that drank and smoked that, like, affected your viewpoint on it?
Not really. I know when my mom was young, she had some issues with alcohol that were pretty serious, but really early on, like probably in her 20s, she kind of resolved those issues. And definitely when I was born, that was never an issue for us. So not really. But my mom had like a really weird childhood, and she grew up in kind of a rough place, and she always talked to us about that and like how it influenced her and why she doesn't do certain things because of that. So yeah, I guess she's like, she talks to me and my sister about that a lot, and it's like even when they're really little, she tells things like that that made me not want to do certain things, or that made me think, that kind of formed my opinions on things.
How about your sister? Does she have the same viewpoint?
I don't actually think she feels as strongly about it as I do. Sometimes I worry about her a little bit. But mostly though, I trust her. And I think that, like it's kind of weird. Usually, I feel like I'm more responsible for her than my parents. Sometimes, like, because they don't, she doesn't tell them as much as I do. I tell them, and she talks to me about those things more. So I try to always listen to what she tells me, and I don't know. But I do try to, like, because me and her talk about that stuff a lot, actually, which is, it's pretty cool. And I told her what I think about it, and I think she mostly agrees with me. Maybe not as, she doesn't feel as strongly as I do, but, yeah.
So is she sort of dabbling, testing things out?
I don't think she is. She's not, like, dabbling, testing things out. But I think, I don't know, I don't think she's done anything yet, but I think she, in the future, she'd be more likely to do something than I would be.
Why do you think she's more susceptible to that kind of peer pressure?
I don't, well, she's going through this, like, little rebellious phase, which my parents say that I went, that, like, I did the same thing too, but I don't think I did as much. Like, sometimes she'll, like, go out with her friends, and she won't tell my parents where she is, and then she'll come back really late, like, especially in the summer. She worked with the wild horses, and she'd get out at, like 9, but then she won't be home until, like, 11, and, like, stuff. I don't know. Nothing really serious happened, but she's just, like, doing stuff that, you know, pisses them off.
Okay.
Naughty.
How would your friends describe you?
I don't know. Probably they would describe me as being really pretty bossy, pretty pushy, but also really considerate, like, because the way that other people feel affects me a lot. Like, if there's someone who, like, I think you're sad, then I'll get really sad, or, like, I don't know. I feel like I've always been really sensitive to that. They probably describe me as, like, as fun, also, because a lot of times, like, as, like, on the island especially, like, it gets kind of boring, but I try to do, like, fun things.
What kind of fun things?
I don't know. I like to go to, like, weird, like, go on a bus, and then, because, like, in the summer, we went to Aquino a lot, because it was, like, it was a nice, like, day activity, because it takes a long time to get there, a long time to get back. And, because, like, there's a lot we can, I don't know, like, on the beach. Usually, though, like, the activity is me taking pictures of them, which some people like more than others. But it's, yeah, I guess I think taking pictures of people has changed the way I relate to them a lot. Especially because I'm doing a portrait project this year. And, like, people getting really getting comfortable with other people, and you can like actually like see like pictures, like a physical representation of the way you relate to someone else.
Do you have any friends your parents don't know about, or that they disagree or disapprove of?
Not really. I mean, my parents were like, my mom is like probably the nicest person that I know, and she's really, like, she starts off liking everyone. Like, she even likes Franklin. Like, I don't know. But probably I would have to say, like, maybe Joe Aguilar and this kid, Music. Like, I hung out with them, like, probably in August and September. Not that much, but, like, I don't know. I think, like, she likes them, but she doesn't know them that well. Although Music, funny story, his mom and my mom knew each other in their 20s. And they were, like, really close. And, so she is actually, like, okay with him because of that. But, yeah, just because they're older. But, I think she's... If we were the same age, she would like them, but... Because they're older, she's, like, blippy. Also, like, Trey and Ian, they're all the same age. They're all, like, 20, almost. But, yeah. She doesn't, because basically it's just my friends are older that she doesn't. Like, so those,
Let's see. What do you do when you get out of school?
Well, after school, most days, I have, like, a planned activity that I have to do. Last year, I had something, like, every day, and it was really, really hard. So this year, I tried to do less. But Mondays, I go to work for Elizabeth Cecil, who's a photographer, and the photo editor of Edible Vineyard, which is, like, a local food magazine. And I do, like, I sort negatives and I help her organize stuff that she gives me. It's kind of like an internship. It's all like that. And that was set up through the school. Like, she contacted the school and asked if anyone would be interested. And then the people at the front desk asked me if I would do it and I agreed to it. Wednesdays. I go to my mentorship, which starts during school, and it's through school. But I usually go past the time school gets out, like 3:30 until like 5:30 or so. And sometimes my mentor's name is David. And if I do, if David wants me to assist him with anything else in the week, I usually do that. So sometimes it can be like more or less. Mentorship time. And then I think that's it for this year. I babysit a lot after school sometimes, like for my art teacher. But the rest of the days I go home and I try to spend time with my friends. More often than, like, because last year I didn't have a lot of time for them and it kind of sucked. So this year, maybe like 2 days a week, I'll do things with my friends and then I'll go home and, like, usually I procrastinate a lot by doing homework. And then I'll eventually do it. Sometimes, like, I get into these weird things where I get really depressed and then I just don't want to do anything. Usually, like, if I get depressed, I'll like, go for a walk and take pictures. Usually, it's at this, like, the town dump, which has a field of solar panels on it that I've been documenting. And I'll go there and take pictures. because it's really nice there, and it's really, like, peaceful.
What do you get depressed about?
Like, the world is just bad. A lot of the things we've been doing in school, it's hard stuff, because it's very real. Like, climate change, and, like, last night I watched, like, this documentary, Food Incorporated, and I read Silent Spring, and then I, like, doing all these other things, and the book I'm reading for English is it's about the Fukushima. That's kind of like the setting, I guess, and it's the time period right after that. It's about Japan, so and like the tsunami and the radioactive stuff was in the ocean, and like my dad is involved with like the shellfishing and fishing on the island. So I hear about that a lot, and like the ocean and the water, there's like so much, and it's like everything, there's like all these problems. That's really overwhelming, because like sometimes I feel like I can't do anything about it, and then like I really want to do something about it, and then I'll get really like energized and excited about it sometimes, but other times I'll get like really depressed.
So your depression stems more from the geopolitical state of our world than like friendship and dating and all that other stuff?
Yeah, for the most part I'd say it does. But I also feel like, I don't know, I get really worried about things a lot, which is just like, just me. Like, I feel like someone who had the same kind of like information coming at them would probably react a lot differently. Like, because I get really freaked out about things. And that's kind of hard to deal with sometimes. I can get really overwhelmed.
Do you feel like the content that you're learning in classes is too much?
I don't feel like it's too much. I feel like it's
too much, like too much too much scary information.
I don't think so, because I think we do stuff in class, and then outside of class, I'll like pursue things on my own. Sometimes, like watching that movie last night, like I didn't have to do that, but I wanted to. So I think I'm choosing to be depressed by that stuff in a way. But I think it's important, and I think you just have to try to turn it into something positive. But I don't know, I think that being depressed is a necessary part of fixing problems sometimes.
Are you involved in any other organizations outside of school?
Organizations like...
Or even inside of school, so like extracurricular kind of groups or clubs or anything like that?
Student government. I'm president. And it's hard because... I don't know. We don't really, like, I don't really know, like, what's even possible or what we could do, and it's really, I'm realizing how hard it is to motivate other people to do things. And, like, last year when I was in student government, not as a president, like, it's really hard to get everyone to agree on things and be motivated to do good things, and then you realize, like, why some of these problems haven't been solved yet, because it's really hard. Yeah. Also in school, I'm the darkroom administrator, and I want to do a lot more with that, but right now I've been trying to get people to like be interested in it and to do it. So.
What does that mean for your time? How much time does that take a week?
At school it takes up a lot of time. Like usually, like every day during our like snack break, I'll go and talk to those people. And then outside of school, I spent with one girl, Lucy, like a couple days in the darkroom after school, like, until like 6 we were there, printing in the darkroom. But I think it does take a lot of time, and especially once more people start doing it, but it's a way that I really want to spend my time, and it's really important. Like, well, because our darkroom at school is student-run, so right now I'm the only one who knows how to use it. And once I'm gone, if I haven't taught another person, then no one else is going to be able to use it. Who's a student. So, I think it's a really important part of our school that I'm trying to, like, keep alive. So it's kind of a big responsibility. But I think, like, at the end of last year, no one really, there wasn't anyone who was really serious about it. But this year, I'm a bit more hopeful.
Are there any other clubs you belong to? Or anything else you do?
Oh, another thing I do there is the Farm Project, which is run by Island Grown Initiative. So, usually it's in the summer. But I did the first winter class, I guess you'd say, or job actually, because you get paid for it. But basically, high school students are invited to go around to different farms on the island and do projects related to farming. And you learn a lot, and you help the community also. Like what we did this year is we helped set up the Martha's Vineyard Community Sea Library at the West Asbury Library, and we did a lot of work figuring out how to organize that, because no one really knew what they were doing. So we helped develop that, and then there was a seed workshop where we taught people, like the high school students and the people who were teaching us, taught other people how to save seeds, and that was important. And that was a really cool thing that made me, like, not so depressed about things. Because, like, seeds are really helpful. It's, like, a way of finding a solution. Oh, yeah. Another extracurricular activity is the Sustainable School Environmental Group. That me and one of my friends started this year. We haven't done a lot of stuff with it yet, but one thing we did that was really successful was, and this is also through student government, but the beach cleanup. We had, which is something that we're going to do in the future, but yeah. We're going to do projects like that that help connect our school community and the island community to the environment. That's basically our goal.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, it sounds like you're a pretty busy person. On a scale of 1 to 10, how ambitious do you think you are?
Probably like 8 or 9. Yeah.
What do you envision yourself doing in 10 years?
10 years, I'll be 26. Probably. I'd like to travel a lot and then come back to the island. But probably 23. I don't know, I'll probably still be traveling or maybe like just starting to do my own photography and like art, like fine art. I don't know. That keeps changing a little bit. There's a couple things in like I want to do photography. But I don't really know like what kind of photography I'll be doing or like where I'll live or anything like that.
Okay. Can you describe a typical school day?
So typical school day. I wake up at usually later than I should, and I run to the bus. I take the VTA, the public bus, instead of the school bus, just because I don't know. My friends take that bus, and it sometimes comes a little bit later. It's more lax in the morning to do that. And then I go to school, and then we have math and Spanish in the morning, or math and facility class, where you work on a year-long project that we can choose anything for. Which is, that's one of the main reasons why I stayed at the school, is that I could do portfolios. I really got it. And then we have a break. And then we have 2 hours. Usually it's like a double period after that. Monday a week we have art. Then social studies, science, or English. Our social studies and science classes are very similar. The theme is social justice. So we've been working on like big projects and that are trying to affect the island community. So it's cool. I like that it's like it seems very real, all the things that we're doing in those two classes. Like it's not just things we're gonna learn about in school and then forget about. Like it seems worthwhile, and like even though like we're still in high school, like we can do a lot. I think that's really cool. I think it's like I think maybe a lot of other people don't realize that or like think about it or appreciate it, but I think it's really cool and important too. Realize that you can actually. So.
What do you think a good teacher is?
I think. A good teacher, well, all the teachers that I have that are really good, they have to know what they're doing. It's cool when you can learn with the teacher, but basically they need to have, like, a advantage, because, probably the most important thing is they have to really love what they're doing, and be able to get other people or their students to see why they love it so much. Because I can tell, like, I think all of my teachers really love what they do, and I think that's pretty awesome. Because I have like friends from other schools, and I don't think that they can say that. I think teachers also need to really care about their students as people, which I think my teachers also do. And they need to do things that will keep us interested, I guess, and be give assignments that we actually want to do and are motivated to do.
How do you learn your best?
How
do you learn best?
How do I learn best? I think taking notes is really helpful.
So, like, for example, listening to a lecture or seeing something or actually doing it.
This year, I think math is a good example, because this year it's all lecturing. That's what this new teacher, or the 11th and 12th grade teacher, does lecturing, whereas in 9th and 10th grade, we all just did independent work. So I like lecturing a lot better for that. But in other classes, I'd probably say lecturing and like group activities, like hands-on stuff. I like doing things as a whole group, rather than doing things individually all the time. I think it's a lot better that if you can listen to a lecture in class and then do something hands-on related to that and then write a paper about it after, instead of doing research on your own and then writing a paper. Which sometimes that's necessary, but
on a school night, how much sleep do you get?
I stay up really late. I stay up till 1 in the morning is like average. But like one night a week, I'll stay up till like 2.
That'll change when you get older, I think.
No, well, my grandmother stays up until like 11. At least, like, you know, my family always, when I was little, I stayed up till like 11 all the time. I've been training.
Do you eat breakfast every morning?
I never eat breakfast at home, but I'll grab like fruit or something when I leave and then eat it at school. Because I'm usually not like really hungry in the morning, but I don't feel that great if I don't eat something, so. Bananas.
Do you feel like the friends that you have now are going to be the same kind of friends that you have after high school?
That's a good question. I don't really know. I mean, I think so. I think based, like, they'll probably have the same, like, they're probably the same kind of people, but I don't know if I'll be friends with people who necessarily have those interests or who act a certain way. Or I don't even know if I'll be friends with these particular friends. I hope so, but then like that can change really quickly, I guess.
Describe something that you accomplished in school that made you proud.
Well, and everything, like, and every, like, I try to be happy with everything I do and like satisfied, but if I was like really proud of something, I don't know. Probably, like, I guess after every year, twice a year, we have project period, which is 2 weeks where you can do any project you want in our classes, or you can do an independent study. Probably my, and after those 2 weeks, you do an exhibition. Probably it would be those projects and those exhibitions that I'm most proud of. But then we've also done things in school that I'm really proud of, like, that were, yeah. Well, we did this newspaper in social studies about climate change, and then, so the finished product is that I was really proud of, and then we kind of, like, brought it to life by going to New York City for the People's Climate March in September. And I think I'm proud of that because we accomplished a lot that day. And we did something really awesome that I don't think enough people can say they have done ever. And it's something I feel really good about. I'm glad I did it.
What was the march about?
It was about climate change and how governments around the world aren't doing enough to stop climate change.
Okay. Do you read a lot?
Yeah, I do read a lot. I really like reading. When I was little, I read a lot more. Like, I read all the time. Me and my cousin, who were at the same school, had this contest about, like, who could read the most books in the Magic Treehouse series. And when I was little, I'd like to read a lot. Like, I'd memorize books and I'd read them in the dark before I could read. At least that's what my mom says. I'm not that true. But yeah, I like reading. I think it's really relaxing. And like, I think sometimes one of the things I get worried about is how I spend my time. Because sometimes I feel like I'm not, a lot of the time I feel like I'm not doing enough. Or like that doing certain things with my time. And then when I feel like that, I usually read, because things like, it's a good use of time. And like, basically, if I'm bored and I don't have anything to do, I'll read. As like a, yeah. It sounds like I only do it if I'm bored, but like, I wish I had more time to read.
Don't we all?
Yeah.
What is bullying to you?
Bullying is when you try to hurt someone else. To me, bullying is something that's repeated. It's something that's like continuous. And usually it's not very, you can't really justify it, I think. Like, if you snap at someone and you get a little bit angry at someone and you have a reason for it, and it's like, I think getting angry at someone and like saying something mean to them is a lot different for me.
Do you witness bullying and clique type behavior at school?
Yeah, a little bit. So there's a group of boys at our school, and I like to refer to them as the bros. And there's, can I say names? I feel like people are mean to Dale a lot. I think that's kind of lessened though, like in 5th and 6th grade. I think it was pretty bad, but then like now I think it's gotten a lot better. I mean, like, it's still not, the situation is still not perfect, but like, I think it's gone a lot better with that, and like, they all can deal with that a little bit better, and like, not bully other people, first of all, but also, kind of like, if that happens to someone, like, they can recover from that a little bit more and not let that determine who they are. I think in general, like, I think a lot of times in high school, like, people can either get better at dealing with that and like be like more mature and nice to each other, or you can get like really like ridiculous and mean to each other.
Is Zale a boy or a girl?
Zale is a boy.
Okay,
it's
sorry.
All boys.
Okay, it's all boys.
Yeah.
So, why do you think you get picked on?
I think it's something that was like decided or for some weird reason like a really long time ago. Like probably when they were really young, like before I even came to school, and they just like, that's just like the way things work, and they just kept doing it. But yeah. I know, I think that's really interesting. Like, a lot of times the way people treat other people is based on something that like, could have happened a long time ago and isn't really